has never read anywhere that when God appears to a person, he should build an altar. He gets to Canaan, God appears to him, he raises an altar. Why did Abraham build an altar? It is because Abraham understood that we immortalize divine encounters by raising altars. We seal God's promises by altars that we raise for God. Every time we raise an altar, we are sealing something that heaven has echoed. We are making it permanently established on the earth. Everybody that is great, everybody that is standing anywhere that is strong, anybody that is up is standing there on the platform of an altar. There is an altar that is speaking. Your relevance is only sustained by an altar that is speaking for you. Whether you are aware of it or not, there are certain things in your life that are not happening, not because you are not fasting enough, not because you are not praying enough, not because you are not good enough. There is an altar that is perpetually designing your work, designing your life and experiences, that have given spirit legal right. Why would Abraham be in an altar? This is the father of faith. Take note, Abraham lived under the covenant of faith and the covenant of promise. Abraham was not under the covenant of law. He operated by the covenant of promise, which is the same covenant that Paul speaks in Galatians chapter 3, that we are children of the promise. Yet in the covenant of promise, he raises an altar. Anywhere God gives you an encounter, don't live without raising an altar. That is how you immortalize it and make it an inheritance, not just for you. Because if you don't raise the altar, that experience ends with you. When you raise an altar, it becomes an inheritance.